Jim Crane from Exeter, Maine, and our name of our business is Crane Brothers Incorporated.
Yeah, we grew up as kids and lived right here since I was, we moved into the house, the farmhouse, when I was 7 years old, July 20th, 1969, because Neil Armstrong walked on the moon, and the people that helped us move came in the TV and watched on TV, so I remember that clearly. But yeah, we spent a lifetime with on this stream, my brothers and I. There's a really nice swimming, fishing hole right here. We used to catch trout out all the time. And then when the potatoes were needed water, we would irrigate out of the stream, because that's what we did. You threw a pump in the brook and, you know, irrigated all you needed. So. We were pretty content to dam it in June, remove it in the end of August. It worked. It's a good program for us. And Ben Matthews, I didn't know Ben at the time, kind of came knocking on the door one day and introduced himself, and pretty low-key guy, you know, Nature Conservancy. You kind of, when they knock on the door, you kind of go, what might you want, young man?
The Cranes have agreed to work with the Nature Conservancy as well as our partners at the National Resource Conservation Service to replace two road stream crossings, two culverts that are barriers to fish passage. Fish cannot get through these to access the really phenomenal almost 16 miles of habitat above where we're standing right now.
Maine NRCS is leading the nation in the number of aquatic organism passage projects that we're doing in conjunction with private landowners. This is a very unique opportunity and project that has taken place definitely through NRCS.
So far through the RCPP program, we've completed 66 projects for a total of over 100 miles of upstream habitat.
The plan is to create a natural bottom structure that the stream doesn't really know is there, that will provide passage to fish and salamanders and salmon, hopefully, in the future. Projects like this require everybody to be on board, and so having a structure that the farmer can still access his fields with was really important.
Water is a huge part of our planet, and it has a huge amount of biota, and we can't just only protect land if we're thinking about trying to truly make a difference on a global scale for conservation.
I am ecstatic about the future of stream restoration in Maine. This is what I've wanted to do my entire life, so I'm really excited to be a part of this entire movement within the state.
There's so much momentum around this work right now. We're continuously improving the tools that we have to really select the stream restoration projects that will have the biggest benefit from an ecological standpoint. And so then we're really ensuring that the projects we're working on continue to provide the most amount of benefit for the amount of funding that we have to put towards this work.
We're having benefits for nature by allowing endangered Atlantic salmon to access critical rearing and possibly spawning habitat. And we're increasing the efficiency of the farm and allowing their business to continue to be profitable throughout this. So nobody has to lose money in this process, and nature wins and people win at the same time.
In the end, we're all happy, I believe. We sure are. We have a nice bridge and water source, and you know, a small bridge wouldn't cut it, so this is fully rated for 100,000 pounds. It's 22 feet wide. It's the nicest bridge in the town of Exeter by far. Just go into it with your eyes open, and you know, have a list of what you want done and what you want to see. And there's always compromise. It worked well for us, for our family farm. It worked really well.